Hey everybody, what's cracking? It is Cracking Nation, and today we are going to be picking up our competitive analysis series. Today we're going to be looking at Mega Heracross. Mega Heracross, for those of you who don't know, if you do follow the CSL, if you don't, that's fine too, but you should. If you do, you know that Mega Heracross is the golden boy of the CSL, because Mega Heracross has been drafted 2 times, and Mega Heracross has won championship games 2 times. So, two perfect record, but we're going to be looking at just what makes Mega Heracross tick, as well as where it fits into the tier at in which it resides, being OU. So, looking right off the bat, we start off with Mega Heracross. What's going to pop out to you right off the bat is that 185 attack stat. Bar Mega Medicham, that is the highest attack stat in OU. It is a bug fighting type, which is a very, very unique and quite honestly very effective offensive typing, and it resides at the B+ rank as of right now. It also does have a very respectable amount of bulk, 80, 115, 105, definitely lets it take some attacks, especially neutral hits and resisted hits. It can sponge up quite well, making it a really good fit on a lot of bulky balance teams. Its ability is Skill Link, which it is able to take very good advantage of, because it has access to moves such as Stab, Pin Missile, Rock Blast, Hammer Arm, which is Stab, if you wanted to run that for whatever reason, instead of Close Combat. It has access to Bullet Seed, Rock Blast, and Pin Missile, which are the 3 moves that you'll see very often. It does have a handful of very crippling weaknesses, however, in Fairy, Flying, Fire, and Psychic, but also a handful of very key resistances, Fighting, Grass, Bug, Dark Ground, which means that, honestly, in the end, Heracross does end up being a Pokemon that can really, really fit very, very well on a variety of drafts that are able to support it. Definitely does have some shortcomings, though. Namely, the biggest one that you're going to end up finding is that 75 speed stat. It does get outpaced by today's very offensive meta, and has a hard time landing its attacks because it can get outpaced, burned by faster mons. There are a lot of mons in the tier that can really threaten it, such as that you would expect its bug typing or fighting or just coverage moves to be able to hit, such as Talonflame, Latios, Latias, even mons like Keldeo that can risk scald burns on it. So there's a lot of things that threaten Mega Heracross, so it does require a lot of team support, but I think if you can find the right team to support it, you will not be disappointed with it. Looking at its sets, first up, we got this. This is the only set. There are some variants of it that we can discuss, but this is a standard Mega Heracross with Close Combat, Bullet Seed, Pin Missile, and Rock Blast. Again, of course, the ability is Skill Link. Basically, this is going to be your go-to wall breaker. Adamant Nature is an option, but this does right now Speed Tie, Bisharp, so I do like to run Max Speed on my Heracross in general. But you can obviously EV or do whatever you want to match the needs of your team. Other options for moves include running Hammer Arm instead of Close Combat, although why would you do that? I really don't recommend that. Definitely an option would be to get rid of either, I would say, Bullet Seed or Rock Blast, whichever coverage move you feel like you need less, and replace with either Substitute or Swords Dance. Swords Dance means this Pokemon basically doesn't have switch-ins. Things cannot switch into a Stab plus 2, Close Combat, or Pin Missile. If you opt for Substitute, it does give you that luxury to stay in on an attack such as on a Talonflame switch-in or a Latios switch-in that you might not have been able to do previously, which is very, very crucial. It also lets you avoid things like Will-O-Wisp from a fast Rotom Wash or a fast Talonflame, something like that. Basically, it just lets you avoid status and gives you that kind of predicting luxury that you might not have had otherwise. But again, as I said, it's definitely a Pokemon that requires some team support. It definitely can contribute in terms of wall breaking, but yeah, it definitely requires some team support. And looking at what that team support is going to be for Mega Heracross, the first one that comes to mind is a bird check. Tyranitar is really nice, specifically, and I really go to Tyranitar as the go-to partner for Mega Heracross, because it does share a very, very good defensive synergy with Mega Heracross, but also beats a lot of the answers that Mega Heracross struggles with. So that's going to be Talonflame and Latias. Tyranitar is able to switch into and basically effectively KO almost all Talonflame variants. It's a fantastic bird check. It's also able to pursuit trap a lot of Latias. So I really think Tyranitar is a great option if you are looking for a partner for your Mega Heracross. Next up, we have Thunderous. Thunderous is a really great option because it is fast. It just kind of helps you patch up the speed. But it also not only fast, but gives you Thunder Wave. And the ability to Thunder Wave your opponent's entire team is very, very efficient, because it just lets Mega Heracross outspeed things that it couldn't have otherwise, and that can be huge late game or mid game when Mega Heracross is trying to wall break but doesn't want to get KO'd. Finally, you have slow pivoters such as Defensive Rotom and Defensive Lander's T. Slow pivoters are really nice to give you a chance to switch in your Heracross for free after taking a hit. So again, that's going to be Pokemon like Rotomwash, Landrestarian, so on and so forth. This is Pokemon that can get those slow speeds that combine with the pivoting move. Spudgily just sponging up a hit, getting your Wall Breaker in for free. Mons that really threaten Mega Heracross, you're going to see things like Talonflame, just birds in general. Birds tend to be fast and be able to KO it with any flying type move that they even think about running. So obviously Heracross fears them a lot. It's also very hard because birds tend not to be able to switch into Heracross just because it runs Rock Blast so often to kill birds. So you don't get the luxury of running, you don't get the luxury of hitting them on a switch-in very often. So that's going to be something you want to think about. Physically defensive mons that don't take super effective damage from any of Heracross attacks can also be a problem. So that's especially mons like Clefable, Hippowdon if it's not running Bullet Seed, so on and so forth. They can be very problematic as they can just recover off of damage in either status or fire back. Clefable can do either one of those at your Heracross, really crippling it. Latios finally is another issue, as Latios is very powerful, just Latios in general, and they can hit your Heracross very hard with a Psy Shock. Of course, in the case of Talonflame and or just birds and Latios, you can strike back very hard, obviously, but you don't usually get the chance to, and that really is because of that really just painful speed stat that Heracross struggles with, which is probably why it falls as low in the tiers as it does, rather than being an A-ranked Pokemon. But finally, in summation, Mega Heracross is a mon that you will need to be able to support very effectively if you want to use it to its fullest potential, but should Mega Heracross get the chance to fire off attacks on an opposing team, not much is going to be able to come into this absolute monster, and you should definitely consider giving it a shot. With that, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a comment, rate, subscribe, like, whatever, all that good stuff. It is always very appreciated. Hopefully, we'll be able to pick up this episode, this series a little bit more often from now on. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and as always, I will see you guys later. Kraken Nation, out. And just click Morning Sun from here.